Hi, and welcome to this new SMOD Academy session. So today, I'm Francis Mas, the founder of SMOD, and today I'm with Basil Rouault, which is product specialist at SMOD Tech. Hi, Basil, how are you doing?
Hi, Francis. Good, good. So today, we learn how to transform CAD to SMOD.
So yes, so let me say a few introductory words about this. So the typical case when you work with SMOD is that very early in the project, you want to have a SMOD project. And this will enable you to preview the stage, preview some concepts, graphical concepts, for example, either simply on the screen by navigating in 3D or with an Oculus device, for example, to have it in virtual reality. And this SMOD project will be the basic canvas that everybody is going to use in the project afterwards. So both on the content design side and the technical side. So it's really something really fundamental making this project. And basically, in general, we as input of this process, we have a CAD file and some PNG files, for example, that describe content maps, pixel mapping, and so on. And there is a big part of the job, which is to convert those CAD files into files that will be usable for real-time purpose inside SMOD. And I think today's session will be specifically focused on this. So which are the type of files you get as input, the raw files that you can have from the architects or the light designers or whatever, and what process you follow in order to construct, convert them into something usable inside SMOD and construct the project inside SMOD. So that's today's topic, and I will let Vasil start.
Yes, thanks, Francis. So let's start directly by looking at the file I have for the start. So I have some PDF, and let's open this this one, and we can see the stage we will try to do. So I have the PDF, and also have DXF, which is an export from AutoCAD, for example, or other software. I have also the pixel output needed by the LED processor, so it will be the output of SMOD. So I will not do all of them to shorten the time of the live, but it's the same principle for every output. And also, I have some Illustrator file, which let's open it and see what they contain. And we see it's about the same as the PDF, so it's not useful for us, maybe. And also, I have some mirror for the input, so for the mirror which will be used by the creator, which will create the show. So let's start by opening.
Yes, this is what we call usually the pixel maps.
And, yes.
There are two types of pixel maps. Content pixel map, which are layouted for content design purpose, and the output pixel maps, which are more layouted for technical purpose. So typically, many different signals can be packed into one single full HD signal, for example.
Yes, we can see here.
In the output, so this is driven by technical issues, letting all the signals fit in the number of channels we have. And on the other side, the content pixel maps are more driven by content design issues. So how do I make it convenient to create content into the whole set of screens? And here it will typically be a 2D unfolding of the stage, so in some logical 2D canvas, which makes it easily accessible. We can send any smooth composition into the canvas, and it will have sense to do this.
Yes, thanks, Francis. So let's see what contains the DXF file. So for this, I open Blender. And for importing DXF file into Blender, there is an add-on. If we look for DXF, I already enable it. So it's for importing DXF file. So let's try to import this file and see what it contains. And as we can see, it's very light stage, the creation of the... It's very light, so we don't have a lot of objects everywhere. We have a lot, but some are not useful, so we can just delete it very quickly and do the cleanup easily. I will show you also in this folder, I have another project, another stage, and I will show you, this is the FBX I received. It's heavy, it's 6 megabytes, and I imported it into Blender to see what it looked like. And as we can see, this FBX file is not like the other one, or for this other stage.
Maybe, Basil, you can tell us which projects these are?
Yes, so this first project is for Les Enfoirés, 2019.
Okay, so le concert des Enfoirés for the French audience. So
yes.
The big concert happening in France. Okay.
And this is for a small permanent installation in Paris.
Okay.
So as we can see, the is flipped. So maybe we need to rotate it, for example. And as we can see, every time I do something, it's very slow because there is a lot of objects. So a big cleanup is needed because the spot don't like to have a lot of objects. And also it will be much easier for Smod and for the user to create his stage pre-visualization. So for...
To make this point very clear, so the bottleneck in Smod is the number of elements you have in your stage. So it's okay to have like 10 objects with 100,000 vertices each. But if you have 1,000 of very small objects, it will be slow. So the objects can be very big, very complex. This is not an issue, but you should limit the number of different objects you have. This is the main bottleneck.
Yeah. And so for cleaning FBX like this, the main purpose is to select all the objects that are similar. For example, if I select the roof, and maybe not this. And I just press Control G. To make it into one object. So for Smod, it will be easier. And after in Blender, we have collection. So if I select again my object, I can create a new collection called Smod. So every time I have done an object, I can move it to the new collection and when with the number I can previsualize the number 1, 2, 3 or just hide the first collection. I can previsualize the objects that are used in this mode and if it's enough for previsualization in this mode. And after I can delete all the objects into the composition and do my FBX export. So if I go, as we can see, I have already made this simplification. So we can see now that I have less objects. So it will be easy for mode. And also, we don't have every object. I have deleted some objects into the stage, which are not useful because we don't see it, or it's a too small object like this. So let's switch back to the Les Enfoirés stage and start doing some pre-processing for force mode. So we can see that the we will not use all of this, so we can just delete it. And then we have a lot of small pieces here, this, and also some elements here. So maybe we don't need these two here, so let's delete it. And I think for going faster and doing the live a little shorter, I'll only do the center part and will not do the extreme part of the other part. So as we can see here, we have some triangulated object, and to make it easier, I will trig the so it's a tree to quad function, so it's all quad face. And then we can see also we have some duplicated edge, so I can press A, Alt M, and merge by distance. And now, normally, if it's not too close, it's not so close. So, the vertices, so let's increase it a bit. Okay, now normally it's merged and it will be better. Also, I have some many objects, so I will separate each. Because it's a different screen. Okay, so now I have all my elements separated.
So basically what you need for SMOD is one object for one screen.
Yes, so here I have my different objects. So as I said earlier, I will create a new collection. So it's all inside the good collection, so I can view quickly which object I need. And then here we can see that this is the placement for the screen, but there are all flat. So a quick tool is to have the vertex snapping, so I will move like this, and we can see it's placed directly on the right position. And also, I will do an origin reset. So origin to geometry. So all screen anchor is centered on the screen. So for the CAD to this mode, it's always a little bit repetition of one action every time, because there are many objects. So if we have some question, maybe Francis.
No, we don't have questions yet.
Okay, very good.
It's indeed somewhat repetitive sometimes to do this, but
so no. Normally, I have all my screen placed. I don't know what this is, so let's just look at the stage, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4 here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I think it's it is. So I will not do it. So now I have all of my objects, and I can view this collection. And this is the collection I will use for first mode. And in tooth mode, there is some important before exporting, because Spot detects the name of the object. So if it's called lead, or so if we tape stage, we have a topic about this. So we see here object named LED will be imported as free shape LED screen. So I want this to be a LED screen, because in the technical document is LED LED screen. So I will rename all of this LED screen. And object rename, I don't remember the shortcut. Selected, and set name. New. So all of these are named LED. And maybe I can rename it after into tooth mode, but the screen have some name. If we look at the pixel map, so maybe it's the best to name it like this. So I'm putting the pixel map on my second screen just to be faster.
Yeah, I think you can name the first ones. You get the idea.
Yes.
You need the names for the next step.
It's faster for the next step, but.
Yeah, so do it then. Show us the right example. So.
And after it's all
We should have planned a little waiting book.
Yes. And after is all colon 1, colon 2, colon 3. So maybe.
Yeah, I could sing a song indeed. I should bring my guitar or something.
Renaming is very important always. And this one four five. This is 5 and this is 4. I have 2 colon 6 on the pixel map. So
I think it's symmetric.
I know, yes.
Everything is symmetrical?
So no, not really. Not it's a little weird. But so I will rename it like this. 5.1. That one.
Yeah. Let's be precise.
Yes, and okay, so now I select everything because I don't delete the other collection, but I did. I can select everything and do FBX export because I selected it and I don't want to export the other object. I select an object only and directly go to my folder into my smart file. So screen and export. Oh, it's very fast because there is not so much. And let's try to import it into smart. So let's create a minimal project and smart. Okay, let's go into the stage and see if it's working. So here we have some options. So as I said in the it's as a group and it will detect the LED screen and everything, and it created the screen. Yeah. Because if it don't detect the name correctly, it will be surfaces. So now everything are disconnected. So what we need to do is to create the and also maybe we can do this because it's not underground. So now we need to create
a question, Basil. Yes. Asked if it works also for LED fixtures or for LED tubes and this kind of things.
Yes, but it will not. You don't need. You need to not import it as a group. You need to make a separate FBX for the fixture. So if I import this as a fixture, it will convert the FBX depending on the geometry into fixture. If we test it, we can see it created some fixture for the 4 point of each element. So it created one fixture at each vertices of the face. So for fixture, it needs to be separated this if you have a fixture on the screen.
I think that there is a documentation topic on this also.
Yes, and we have done a live on the fixture.
Yeah, so and it's worth showing the topic again.
Yes, we can throw the file as fixture. So here we have it. And it's not completed, so weird.
So more for you, it sounds like.
Yes. And also from the SSV file.
Yeah, for the fixtures.
And, yes.
Yeah, the other question is how many outputs are you going to create? But you will explain us.
Yes. Yes, after the first, we do create the content part generally. So the people who work on the different creation on the show can start using the stage to previsualize their content. So. As we can see, I have a mirror for the so it's the same. So we can put the map here. So I have it here, and put the same scale into the content map because it's the content. So it's good.
So while you do this, I can answer to another question we have is, do we need Blender to do this? And actually all of this could have been done in SMOD directly. But what happens in the practical case is that you have a plan and you want it to be really precise compared to the plan. And what Basil showed is really the efficient way to get the exact information, because if you do everything in SMOD, you won't have all the facilities that you have inside Blender in order to position things, align things, and so on. So the more complex the stage is, the better it becomes to use a dedicated 3D modeler in order to ease the whole process.
Yes, and also, because here we don't have a stage previs, but for example with the other project of the I show you with the big FBX, we need to import also into SMOD the stage previs to show to the client. So the building we cannot do it into SMOD easily, and Blender is free, so it's a good solution. So let's create the different area because we need to send each part of this content map to the stage, and after reorganize it into a processor for the output. So we can see we have the pixel dimension of each area, so we can put it directly here. By and here I have the good dimension, and to put it on the right corner, I can switch back to here % and place the anchor to the left corner. Okay, and place this here. So it's on the right position. And I can duplicate it.
So you are going very quickly, Basil, but let me stress the pixel button in the top bar.
Yes.
because this one is really important. If you want to be pixel perfect, you should work with pixels and not percentages.
And we can also type percent into the bar to convert it to percent. So it's we don't need to be in percent mode to enter percent. So if I name it before, it will automatically change the number at the end. So easier for us. Okay. And then. Okay, no ID size. Hope it's not too long.
We really are missing the waiting music. I can put one on my YouTube, but it won't be very good quality.
Okay, and here we have some overlapping, but it's not very bad because the screen are very close, so we don't see the overlapping in the read. In the early stage. So let's make this big screen.
So while you are doing this, maybe I can also stress a bit on something you did quickly, which is setting the anchor. But this is really a critical step here because basically the anchor says which coordinate are you going to enter. Are you going to enter the position of the center, of the top left corner, of the middle left corner? It could be any position within the screen. And typically, so by default it's the center, but typically when doing this you want it to be like top left position, for example. And once you have configured the anchor like this, in this case it's bottom left, because everything is grounded on the floor, so it's really project dependent, which will be the most efficient way to do it. Once you have specified the anchor, then the position that you enter in the second parameter will directly correspond to something relevant, which is easy to set. So always choose your anchor very carefully. You will win a lot of time afterwards.
Yes.
So since the stage is partly symmetrical, we can duplicate the elements from the left side in order to create the elements from the right side. And in order to duplicate, you have two ways to do it. Either you use the Ctrl D. But in this case, since we want the content map to reflect the order of the screens, it's better to use the control drag and drop, and then it will directly both make a copy and enable you to position it nicely in the list of area. Content. So that's with control drag and drop.
Yes. And free. That one. And it's, yeah. For the last screen, I can also do, as Francis say, with the anchor, let's place the anchor to the right and set the position to the full right, so it's at the good position. And then the top, let's take this. Here we don't have a precise way to know where they are, because it's not very easy, but we have the size, so I will put the size of the screen. And after placing the center, I will do the correct position. So this one is in the center normally. So let's place it to the center. No, it's the center of the LED of the of this one.
Yeah.
So let's place it like this, and it's not very bad for this creation.
Pixel map isn't very accurate.
Yes.
Oh, did you enter the correct resolution?
Yes. It's a little weird. Five by five.
Yeah. So it's probably the pixel map which is slightly.
Yes.
And also here, you are discarding the shape of the screen. But the question is, how do you remove the two little parts from the screen called Cascade Central?
Here.
Yes.
We see that we have a mate. I think I don't know if it's with this one. Yes. So we have a mate of this content map. So we can do. We see it in the live with Chris Marquez for doing the circle. We can use a mask and a layer mask into this content map and use the mask as a generator, and channel alpha and invert it, and here the top is masked.
Yeah, everything we send there will be masked.
Yeah, so let's save, and now we have all the screen, and maybe okay, and this now let's assign each element of the stage to the correct so let's select all, and after I click one, and after clicking one and clicking a second time, the case, the box is selected, so I can press the up arrow and down arrow to select my correct element. And also, as we can see, I forgot something. Into the process of FBX. So let's switch back to Blender and show you what I forgot. If we go to the UV editing, we see that the UV are not good at all. For all my objects, they are nowhere. So let's do the UV mapping of all of this. UV mapping is very important because otherwise it will not work.
Yeah, so as a reminder, the UV mapping is the 2D coordinates which are attached to every vertice of the 3D object and that say where to look up in the content in order to associate content texture to the object.
Yes.
UV coordinates really play a critical role, and then they will correspond to what we put in our content maps. So the way the content from the content map is mapped onto the 3D objects, be it LED screens or surfaces, depend on the UV coordinates.
So let's export this again. I can overwrite it. So it will be in tooth mode, and if we go to the geometry, and normally if I press reload, it will reload automatically. And we can see there is some problem also with...
I think you are, you are on the wrong side of the stage, no?
No, no. Ah, yes, maybe. Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. The door is on the back. And no, maybe I have this. Yes. So let's. And also, so.
So you still need to.
I need to do. Yes. So this is the first one. So this is the first one, the second. Four. And five and the six are mismatch. Five, six.
So now we can understand why it was important to keep the names.
Yes. Six, one. Four. And the last one here. Okay. Now we have this and the top part. So. Yes, and see, I don't know if I make the placement right into Blender, but it's not very bad. And as we can see in the front view, it's the same as the content map. So the content map is a representation of the stage, but flattened.
Maybe you can show us with the test bar, test pattern with the moving bar.
Yes, we can. Send.
Make some
moving bar here.
Oh.
Okay, let's.
No license of mode.
I think Let's view what happened. Okay, my license disappear.
Save.
Okay, let's save it and we will switch if the dongle don't go back. And yeah.
So now
CodeMeter have some issue. So let's try to restart the CodeMeter.
So CodeMeter is the license protection system from Swan.
Yeah.
And that's currently what happens if we unplug the dongle from Swan.
Yes, but yeah, the dongle is not unplugged. The dongle is a remote dongle because it's the server. So we use an app to use remotely the dongle. And I think the top corner, so I cannot ignore anymore. So let's cancel.
Yeah, you should switch to the Smart Academy version,
which yes. works
on the cloud servers. And by the way, we do offer on our website a 1 hour free offer to access those Smart Academy servers. And there you have access to a version of Smart Designer called Smart Academy with a very nice logo, and which you can use for free during 1 hour from the servers.
Yes.
I think this version will do everything we need.
Yes, I don't have output, but we don't have the content today, so output will be for next time, I think, because it's already 1 hour, almost. So, yeah, so it's best to do the... So, where is my content? Okay.
Again, we are the wrong side, yes.
Yeah, let's flip it. And so, where we was, and I think the colon one here, yeah. I found a mismatch. So, yeah, it's good. Better. So,
no, why it is important to use this moving bar test pattern?
Yes, because
was the final result. Yes.
Yeah.
So see, that's really the very efficient way to validate the pixel mapping.
Yeah. So maybe Francis, do you have some? Do you have some question? No.
No, we have no questions more than before. I think everything was very clear.
Okay.
Continue.
But I think we finish for the creative part. So, no, what do you think?
Let me just check. So, what could we possibly forget? Was the pixel? Yes, we have a question. Is the pixel mapping part for fixtures? So it has been explained in the fixture session. So you should have a definitively look to the fixture session.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe you can say us a word about this quickly because we are talking about pixel mapping.
Yes, we can. So let's, I will just create a new content map for this pixel. Let's make it small. So here, I have some content map and create so a fixture definition. So I can create some fixture on pixel and can assign to my content map. Once I have my first fixture created, definition created, I can create instances of this pixel, and we can see it's here. We can make it a little bit bigger, and so we see it very well. And if we go to the stage, we see that there is a small point on the top here. If I and if I create some other LED, let's duplicate this one, we will see there are automatically placed like this into the content map. So it's because the UV coordinates are in automatic mode. But if we want to move this elsewhere, we can activate this and place it everywhere in the content map. So, for example, in the middle. And as we can see, it updates also the fixture below this fixture. So each fixture will follow even if the UV coordinates are not selected. So if we go back to the content map, we see that the fixture are placed in the middle and the first are automatically placed here. Also, with more complex fixture like an array, so if I make a small array of single LED, we see that the fixture are placed even or vertically, horizontally, or vertically. So each face of the LED are placed like this. And also, when you import a fixture from FBX, the UV of this FBX are used. So you can either use manual UV. The FBX will set to manual UV. But if the UV is not good for you, you can switch to automatic UV and it will automatically place it the best way into the content map.
Thank you.
I think it was clear.
It's clear, and for the rest, watch the dedicated episode to this.
Yes.
You will have much more information. But indeed, it can be part of the whole process of CAD to projects. If you have an hybrid stage with both video and fixtures.
Yes, and also SV an export from LED. I don't know the name. I don't remember the name of. Which export SSV, CSV file of the position of each LED. It's like CAD to a smooth workflow. And
yes, it's very similar. So for example,
yes.
If you are using the WYSIWYG Lightning.
Yes, WYSIWYG.
You are able to export the CSV file from WYSIWYG, which contains all the fixtures from the stage. And then this CSV file, you will be able to import it inside SMOD. So that's exactly how the CSV file looks like. And the import will automatically create all the necessary stuff. So typically for video, you need to handle a 3D modeler and know exactly what UV coordinates are. For Lightning, it can be either via the CSV workflow or using an import from dedicated models that only concern the fixtures, the location of the fixtures. So apparently my sound became very low and I cannot hear you anymore, Basil.
Yeah, yes, so sorry. Yes. I think we can stop here for this first part.
Okay, perfect.
And in the next part, we will do the end of the pipeline, so the processor. It will be a little bit faster. I think it will be a small live, but it takes some time. to explain you correctly.
Properly on the mapper.
Yes, the different way to arrange the pixel map for the output.
I guess we will put this file available as a download on our website as usual, as deal, so that anyone can check what you did today.
Yes, I can put the not the FBX because I don't have the right on it, but all this file, the MIR, the DXF, and also the small file, the blend file I did for this. Yes, so let's save it. And
so I think the last thing to do is to tell you what's next, and the next live will be this Friday in 2 days, and I'm going to show you some new features on which I'm currently working on. So the first one is 3D channels. So basically a content map is a channel with a texture inside, and the 3D channel is a new type of channel that I just created, and which enables to push 3D scenes from the show into the pipeline. And this, I will show you why we need this in the context of augmented reality and mixed reality. And by the way, I will show you 2 new cameras that we are putting into SMUD. One is the virtual reality window camera, and the other one is the tracked camera. So I will show you all of this Friday, and enjoy your evening in the meantime, and see you on Friday. Thank you, Vasile, for the session today, and enjoy.
Yes, bye.
Bye-bye.